Time to get with it, ain't it?
Yup. Here we go. Here comes the dump truck driver.
Across the state line, Mark and Digger are back at their still site with Killer Beaz.
Let's see what we got here, puss.
To get a first taste of their new oatmeal cinnamon raisin mash.
I guess it's got some octane to it. That smell is just phenomenal. You know, it's got the brown sugar, it's got the oats, and it's got the raisins. You know, once we pack this column full of cinnamon, we'll find out whether we made good liquor or buttermilk.
You get your stuff going, and we'll get this one going.
Anything you need, man, holler.
You know, Killer Beaz, his mash barrels, he mashes in entirely separate from our tote barrels. He actually has one that's ready to run, so there's no need of wasting him. We can get 6 gallons more of good corn liquor. You got it running?
Oh, yeah.
We're fixing to make some wicked popcorn, you say. We're gonna make some wicked today.
I'm real confident about the run of corn. Mark and Digger have taught me well. I've got the fundamentals down, but they have never run oatmeal, raisin, cinnamon. That is a big deal.
Watch your legs. All right, it's perfect, Hattie boy.
All right, let's get this going.
All right. How are you going over here, Puss?
I'm a snuffy smithing right now.
That's all right.
These rags were just actually a joke that we did this the first time. Popcorn's the one that did it. He read the Sunday paper and saw Snuffy Smith. He thought that's the greatest thing in the world. We started doing it. It keeps your paste joints moist. They don't dry out as crack as bad, so they don't turn loose. And sometimes out of a joke comes one of the greatest ideas in the world. All right, we're warming up here.
Yeah,
everything's going good. It ain't nothing but a little bit of time now.
A little bit of waiting.
All right, I'm gonna get some jars set out of this tub over here. Oh, well now.
Are you teasing me? We forgot to put the damn cinnamon in it. You know, we've got muscle memory here, and we just totally forgot to put the cinnamon in the thump arm because that's not what we normally do.
Damn it.
We'll break it down right there and slide it in the arm. Our pot's heated up, so we've got to pull it apart. I've got to build the mesh bag full of the cinnamon, cram it in the arm, and put it back together.
That defeats the whole purpose if we don't get that in here.
This is copper mesh. It's the same thing they make pox scrubbers out of. You buy at the department stores. And as the steam goes through, it's gonna pick up just a subtle amount of this wonderful cinnamon. Not a do-all, end-all. I'm just glad we caught it now before it got too late.
Y'all, I'm about to start producing over here.
You get with it, good boy.
We hope you are.
Holy moly. Oh, there it is, right there. Woo! Dude, that's corn liquor moonshine. Holy moly.
I thought it was gonna be peanut butter.
Dude, that thing is running sweet right there. What can I help you with?
You just keep an eye on your liquor.
Look at here,
we got liquor now.
That's what we're looking for. That's the way Daddy like it.
That ought to be a plenty, Hattie boy.
Pretty clear for heads.
Yep.
I actually come around from back here, didn't I?
Yep.
Ain't touching it no more. Guys, it's running, is it?
Y'all, nope. Check this out.
Let me see what you got here, Keller.
Is it all right?
Yeah, it's all right.
Did it the way you taught me.
That's good, Beaz. That is excellent.
That
taste
is
that
good.
Us.
Ooh.
Cold?
Yeah, that's the thing, Beaz. When it comes out that cold, takes that fire out of it. I'm really, really proud of Beaz. He's doing a good job. He's pulling his weight, and you can tell how excited he is. He's giddy as a little girl, but honestly, he's got every right to be proud.
I think this is the end of this run, guys. I'm gonna cut this off.
Beaz, you get yours finished up. We're gonna dump this first run of the rich lady's liquor.
And away we go.
Don't spill it.
Make your mind up. Do I hurt myself or do I spill it?
Well, if you got a choice, hurt yourself. Our still's beginning to run. We hope to have a lot of liquor out of here, but you know, it's just the nature of the beast. You never know what you'll get. Digger, she's slowing down a little, our baby man. It's about had it. We're not gonna get no 40 gallon.
No.
Car hits about had the lid.
Yep, it's a flickering. Here we go.
Damn.
That thing that put her to the top, we got about 30, I'd say. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Oh, that's fine looking liquor. If it tastes as good as it looks,
Boy, that sounds good. Beaz, come here.
Mm. All right, I am excited. What happened here?
Well, we got a bad happening and we got a really good happening.
And that's outstanding.
Can you believe how strong the taste of that raisin cinnamon is? I was blown away. I'll be honest, I had no idea you could make moonshine that actually tasted like cereal. All right, 30-gallon barrel, is that what we got?
That's the bad.
Yeah, that's the bad.
That's the only bad news.
The cinnamon hit just the note that we wanted it to. I only wish there had been a little more of it, but she has to take the entire run, be it 40 gallons or 30 gallons.
This is right up her alley. I didn't know if we could pull it off, but oh my gosh.
You about ready to start doing that thump keg boogie?
I just can't hear the music keep time with
popcorn. He said faster it goes, said you do that thump keg boogie.
If you've got a rhythm in that thump keg, that's your barometer for your run. And you can feel that rhythm. That's what Popcorn always liked. He liked to do what he called a thump keg boogie.
Start
real
out real slow.
Faster it get. Faster she'd get. He'd keep him arm just steady. He'd be stomping them little feet.
That thump keg boogie.
That last note hit.
Yeah, always.
Stomp.
Damn quit, this corn down my face.
Dude, this is a big deal to me. This is great.
Pretty big deal to us, Beaz.
Good, good. Let's do more like this. That's my plan.
Yeah, we'll do as much as you can sell.
Beaz is gone with this load of this special run that we made. She's taking it to his high caliber buyer. Evidently, she's flying in on her private plane. I can't imagine taking 30 gallons of liquor to an airport.
I am driving onto federal airport property with 30 gallons of illegal liquor. So hopefully we can get this deal done quick. I do not like being here.
Bootlegging is the most risky part of this business. The fact that Beaz won't sell this liquor, it's a tremendous amount of help. That takes that worry away from us.
How the heck are you, darling? Oh my God. Hey, that part, I tell you what, I've got you hooked up. Check that out, my dear.
Man, that's good.
Okay, now we ended up with 30 gallons.
Ouch. Okay,
so at 150, that's $4,500.
Okay.
So if you'll stay set, I'm going to start bringing the stuff out.
Oh, that's
so
perfect.
You love it?
I love it.
Excellent. Yeah.
You know, we knew how valuable Beaz would be to our organization, the buyers that he brings to the table. You know, we understand his value here, and that's where we benefit for having him.
All right, see y'all later. Thanks, guys. Yeah, safe travels.